Hello, Fabiolas, the bar here. Today I'm in San Francisco, here near the Golden Gate Bridge, to explain you how to use photopills to plan next total solar eclipse that's happening on August 21st, 2017. It's gonna be crazy here in the US, so let's go for it. Living a total solar eclipse is a unique experience. You know, when the moon goes just in front of the sun, covering the sun completely, the sky gets dark, you can see the stars, and you can see a ring of fire around the moon. It's amazing. The catch here is that the total solar eclipse is not visible from anywhere in the world. It's only visible in certain locations. So let me show you how to use photopills to find where to go and when to go to see the total eclipse. Let's go to the photopills planner. Okay guys, let's go to photopills and tap on the planner. Tap on the planner. And what you see here is the map view of the area. The red pin is place where I am now, here near the Golden Gate. You see the Golden Gate here, and you have Alcatraz over there. So where the total solar eclipse will be visible? Let's find out. Let's use the eclipse tool. So swipe the panels to the right, to the left, until you find the first eclipse panel. Now, tap on the button you see on the panel, and you'll see that all the eclipse information will be displayed both on the map and also on the panel that you have above the map. So, for example, the panel is telling me that from the position of the red pin, I will see a partial eclipse. The eclipse type will be a partial one, it's not a total one. And the magnitude is 0.802, which is how much the moon is covering the sun. On the map, you see yellow lines, a blue line, and a dark area. Guys, if you want to see the total eclipse, you need to go within these dark areas here on the map. It is called the path of totality. If you are outside this area and within the area of the yellow lines, you'll see a partial eclipse. And you're outside the yellow lines, you won't see any eclipse. So from here in San Francisco, we'll be able to see a partial eclipse. So let's move the red pin into the dark area where the total eclipse is happening, and see how the information updates on the top panel. Now the top panel is telling me that the eclipse type is a total eclipse, cool. And the magnitude is 1.028. It means that the moon is gonna be covering completely the sun. Okay, now you know where to go. Let's figure out when the eclipse is happening. Yes, the total solar eclipse is happening on August 21st, but when? When it's going to be visible, for example, from the position of this red pin. Let's figure it out. Just swipe the top panel to the left and find the second eclipse panel. And here on the panel, you can see the time each of the main phases of the eclipse is happening. For example, at 10 minutes past 10 a.m. in the morning, the moon will start getting over the sun, coming over the sun. At 24 minutes past 11 is when the moon will be almost covering the sun. And at 25 minutes past 11 is when the moon will be covering completely the sun, and is when you will be able to see the stars and you'll be in the darkness. At 26 minutes past 11 is when the moon will start leaving the sun, moving away from the sun, and the eclipse will end at 13 minutes to 1 p.m. So, yes, this is how you figure out the exact time each phase of the eclipse happened. Now, the next question is, where should I frame the camera? Where the eclipse will be happening in the sky? Let's figure it out. Okay, to know where to frame the camera, you need to know where the sun is gonna be during the eclipse. To know it, all you have to do is to set the date and time the eclipse is gonna begin. One way to do it is just tap on the time bar And here you can set the date. Let's set it to August 21st. It's when the eclipse is gonna be happening. And also you can swipe the time bar now and see how the eclipse evolves. Pay attention at the icon you see on the top panel. You see how it changes when I move the time. Okay, there is a smarter way to do it. All you have to do is to tap the button you see on the top panel that has the yellow icon. If I do it, the date has been set to August 21st, and the time has been set to 10 minutes past 10 a.m. in the morning, which is when the eclipse will begin, when the moon will start glowing on the sun. The cool thing about this button is that if I tap it again, time will jump to when the total eclipse is happening. This is 25 minutes past 11 a.m. in the morning. And you see how the icon has updated. Now the icon is showing you a picture of the total eclipse. This is the ring fire you'll see around the moon. Now, if I tap it again, time has been set to 13 minutes to 1 p.m. in the 1 p.m. And it's when the eclipse is going to end. Also notice that the icon has updated again. It's showing me what I will see in the sky at the end of the eclipse. So this is a cool way to set the time of the different stages or phases of the eclipse. Let's go back to the beginning. Tap it again. Okay, I've set the time for the beginning of the eclipse, when the eclipse is beginning at 10 minutes past 10 a.m. in the morning. And on the map, this yellow thin line you see on the map is telling you the direction of the sun, is where the eclipse will be happening in the sky, is where you need to frame the camera, you want to capture the eclipse at the beginning. If I tap it again, let's go to when the total eclipse is happening. This is at 25 minutes past 11. The position of the sun, again, is represented by this yellow line you see on the map. So you know where the eclipse is happening. And where the eclipse will end, tap on the top button again. Here on the top panel, and here you have it. The time is 30 minutes to 1 p.m. And again, the yellow-orange line, the thin one, is showing you where the sun is gonna be. This way you know exactly how the eclipse will move across the sky. Okay, but there is one question that needs another answer, is what's the elevation of the eclipse? You know the direction, but you don't know the elevation. A cool way to do it is to use the augmented reality button for the pills. So let me set the eclipse at the beginning again. So I'm setting the time at 10 past 10 again. So the eclipse will begin in the direction of the thin line, of the yellow thin line. And now if I tap on the AR button that you see at the bottom of the screen, I just have to point out on the sky and see where the sun is gonna be. So the eclipse is gonna be happening in this direction, at this elevation. And this is the sun path of the eclipse, so you know exactly where the eclipse is gonna be moving across the sky. I can swipe my finger from right to left and move time forwards and see how the eclipse moves through the sky. This is one way to do it, to use the augmented reality views. The other way to do it is to swipe the top panels to the right until you find the sun and moon azimuth and elevation panel. Okay, you're getting there. This is the panel. On this panel you can read both the azimuth and the elevation of the sun and the moon. So you see at the beginning of the eclipse, it was more or less at, 10 past 10. Okay, 10 past 10, here we have it. The sun is gonna be at 32.41 degrees of elevation in the sky. It's pretty high in the sky, so you're gonna need wide angle lens if you want to capture the landscape. Awesome guys, this is how you can plan the total solar eclipse. If you're thinking of planning the partial eclipse, it works the same way. All you have to do is to place the red pin where you want to be. Let's say I'm gonna shoot it from here, from San Francisco. I'll use the GPS button to place the red pin where I am. Just tap on the plus button you see on the map. Scroll to the right and tap on the first button you see to place the red pin where I am. Cool. Now just go back to the eclipse panel. Swipe the top panels to the left. And tap the top button until the time is set at the beginning of the eclipse. So you know where the eclipse is gonna begin by looking at the yellow azimuth line that you have on the map, the thin one. Okay, you know the direction of the eclipse. So I'm gonna look for a shooting spot here. Let's go, for example, why don't we go on the other side, just crossing the beach, so I can shoot the eclipse and the Golden Gate, which is a pretty cool, hey, awesome. Don't worry, it's cool. This is spontaneous. I love it. So, yes, I've just placed the red pin right where, right on the other side of the Golden Gate, so I can shoot the Golden Gate bridge and the eclipse. Let's figure out where the eclipse will be happening when the moon covers the maximum area of the sun, when the eclipse is maximum. Just tap on the button again, on the top panel, tap on the button. And the eclipse, this is happening at 15 minutes past 10. And the sun is gonna be right in the middle of the Golden Gate. So guys, easy. Just look for your shooting spot according to the ideas you have. Now you can do it. What do you think, guys? Come on, it's very easy. Now you can use photo pills to plan your eclipse photo ideas. Don't be afraid, it's very easy. As always, thanks a lot for watching and see you in the next video. And remember that you have the power to imagine, plan, and shoot legendary photos. See you in the next video. Bye.